See a brown spot on this leaf here? It's coming off this tree on the left. This tree on the left, it's got some type of a disease, I guess, on it. And it gets over here in the garden. It's all around here. I've been picking it up around the garden, at least. In the garden, I'm trying to pick it up off so it's away from the plant. But it's like going around the border. See, like right here. And here. I can't see if you can see this or not because of the brightness out here. The cameras they have nowadays suck. You can't really view what you're doing in most situations. Just some. If you're trying to do one thing with one hand while you're recording, you can't really look at it. Well, at least I can't. Maybe I'm just... Anyway, see, I'm getting all this up like this. Especially when it gets around the plant, but you gotta get this stuff up and then you gotta wash your hands after something like that too, because you're getting bacteria and stuff from this stuff on your hands. Yeah, those are the same trees then. The back tree up there and the one on the left there of those two trees. The leaves are coming down. See, look at the wind out here has been like hell too. Blowing all over the place. I'm just gonna get these right here right now, but go mainly in the garden. These are black-eyed peas. One is growing. I can't see in the viewfinder, like I said. And my hair is in my eyes, too. But there's one right down into that cage in the center. I can't see it on the viewfinder. And there's a spice there. I put some seeds down. There looks like two growing down there. One or two right here. Nothing. These are purple hull peas from my mom's garden. She had purple hull peas, which you can't get very easily. Right there, look at this. Four of them growing here. I just dropped them. I didn't mean to put so many. I was only putting no more than two. And there's three here. And looks like three here. Purple hull peas. And then this last one here, there's four in here. Purple hull peas. Okay, it's gonna be crowded bushes of peas. It might be vines. Now, these are our black-eyed peas. Look at how good those are coming up. See, and I can hear, see a leaf right here. Contaminating it, plus a piece of grass. Black-eyed pea. Nothing this one, black-eyed pea. Broccoli's coming up in the corner there. There's grass there I gotta get when I'm not videotaping. It's too difficult to get videoing and taking up space for broccoli. Space for broccoli, looks like there might be some. I ate plenty of broccoli. There's broccoli. This is a different type of broccoli, all heirloom broccoli. There's some growing right there, right there, right there, right there. Four sections, I had four sections over there and four here with a different type. So, it's all starting to come up. Another week, look at this zucchini right here. This is the golden zucchini, I believe. This would be the Black Beauty, the green zucchini, traditional type that most people know. God bless it. See, this plastic, I didn't do a better job of cutting it. But it's doing a good job. It's making this stuff grow quick, too. See that zucchini? That's a goldenrod zucchini. Again, I can't see if it's on the video, on the film, on the screen. There, I think that's golden zucchini. Nothing yet. See, look at nothing yet, and then look at these. These are all planted at the same time. Look at how big that one came up already. That one's pretty big. See, it's got that leaf in there. This stuff here, see the leaves on this turning a little bit. Gotta get this stuff out of here, away from these plants. We have a lot of zucchini, which would be good. See, I wanted to get some more sticks, bigger than that sticks, put around these cuts because the wind gets underneath here, and that's how you only get the leaves blown underneath it and whatnot too. So, but I did it in a bunch of them. Let me finish over here. See, more leaves down here. Diseased leaves underneath the plant. Diseased leaf underneath the plant. Gotta watch that brown spot stuff. Decimate your garden. Look at this, all underneath here. See the yellow leaves too on this plant. should have got a bag or something for this stuff. My hands are getting full. So zucchini. We got three rows of zucchini. The first row and two-thirds is yellow golden zucchini. That would be this row here and the one here. And I don't know if it's somewhere in here, then it's green. It's black beauty, which is the traditional green zucchini. See, now that's what gets me aggravated, stuff like this. See these leaves like this with the brown spot on them. This is a honeydew melon. Planted one there. Planted a jubilee and I forget the other type of watermelons. Planted one or two seeds there. Maybe one seed because there's one here and there's one coming up. And then we planted a seed here. Nothing yet. Planted a seed here. You can see that one's coming up. It's in there somewhere. It's a green. That's a watermelon. Then we got the cannatella, whatever it is, Italian bean over here. That one's up. That was one that was in there and it died off. I was hoping it would come back. It may still. I thought I planted another bean in there. There's these leaves too. Okay. Nothing in this cannatella. Then we have cucumbers. I was gonna say pickles. What do you call cucumbers? Two or three there. Two or three there. The brown spot will decimate this. There's two or three there. Nothing yet. There's two here. Cucumber. Cucumber here. See the little leaves that's underneath here? It's already dried up some of it, but see the brown spot on the plant? Gotta get that stuff off. This is more cantonella Italian runner beans here. We planted some here. See, now I made a mistake. I put it here on the north end of the garden. It'll run north. So we're gonna see if we can't get the run on that. Might have to put string back and forth here for run back and forth. And we got it back here so that it'll run that way in that direction. We planted them here. Nothing yet. Wow, nothing yet. I'm surprised on this. Because some of them are up. If some of them are up, the others should be starting. Nothing here. That one right there is starting. Cantonella bean. And then the next row is cantonella runner bean, also Italian bean. You got this one right here, which is about 6 or 7 inches above that one, too. That one drooped over, but it's all green, so it's alive and healthy. When it starts getting longer, we start attaching to the strings. Got one here, here, there, over there. See, every time you see a leaf with many spots on it, try to get that stuff up right away. In the back here, we got that one there, and that one up there. And there was one here we planted, but none's growing up yet. I believe that's a grade of grass. I'm gonna let it grow just a little bit more. Then here's your broccoli. Zucchini. I think that's a zucchini right there, the small one on the right. This one is. That one is. And then you got your burgundy broccoli. Zucchini. There. I said I was over here picking up leaves, getting all the brown spot out of it. Look at how unhealthy that looks. I got the ProtoGrow from Heirloom Solutions, I believe it was, and I put that on fertilizer. It's got fish emulsions in it. It stinks, but it really helps plants. And I'm hoping that will help. I have to put that on there every 3 days or so. I'm going to put it at the. It says to spray it on the plant as well as around the base of it. I sprayed it just around the base because see the sun's out already. It's around 9:30, 10 o'clock right now. And so I can't spray it until before 7 o'clock in the morning. I get up around 5:30, 6 o'clock. Sometimes I don't get out of bed till almost 7:27 or something like that. But see, that's all that. And then the wind's been out here blowing. I was over here earlier and there's already leaves over here. Got a tree out back. Oh man, Oh yeah. See all these brown spot leaves? This is gonna be hard to do. We have to get out here and do this every day. Really sucks too, but once the summer goes, once it gets here about the end of May into June, plants should be way well established enough. Just come out every day and look, and you won't have much to pick up. Anyway, let me get back away. Well, see, we put purple pole beans over here. We planted six. There's one right there. You can see that one. Again, I can't see anything with the sun on this. And there's three rows here. This one here's got one. Come over here. There's three across from each other. You got one right in this row. One right there coming up. This is garden A. Garden A, garden two, which will be tomatoes and peppers. And then garden three will be in the back with all the other stuff, mainly the vines. Then we've got, I believe this is more zucchini. So, and then my tomatillos. They look so frail when they're first coming up. I got a couple pots over by the house. They look really, really like they're just gonna die off. But that's how these looked too before. And I took a chance and I planted them out here when they were a little bit smaller than this, and they look really healthy now. I've got mammoth sunflowers up closest to the garden. And I've got the Titan giant sunflowers in the back. You can see the petals of them all the way down because there's spaces here. I put some down here, I'm trying to fill it up so you have sunflowers all the way down here. Wife put out the seeds for, what do you call those, to keep mosquitoes away. Anyway, she did that on here, but again, I was told that that's a fall flower. So, but in the meantime, it's down here. Hopefully it'll germinate over the summer. Germinate, whatever you want to call it. Down this aisle, this row, edge, border. She did that all the way down. Like I said, with that, I might put peppers in here. Maybe it's some tomato and peppers. We're gonna have eggplant too. Eggplant probably going to back there. This will be all tomatoes and peppers. All the stuff in the store is because they have greenhouses. There's about 18 inches tall already. You know, they're taller than these sunflowers that have been out here for a month. These are the giant sunflowers I have all the way down this border. I stopped at that little walkway and then I went all the way down that way, as you see, and then the back of that big garden I got them. So, that's it. After I get rid of this camera, I'm gonna put the camera in the house, and then I'm gonna start picking up all these leaves around here with the brown spot too, because it's difficult to do with this camera. Everybody, you need to grow something. If you can just grow two things or something, grow a couple things, you know, three or four plants. The food that you're eating is poison. Monsanto, IG Farben is a German outfit back in World War II. I put a bunch of stuff on Facebook about that. It's not Nazi collaborators, hell-bent on poisoning and altering people's genetic makeups even. And not for the good, trust me. But they said that Monsanto is what IG Farben was in World War II with the Nazis. So again, you need to grow your own food as much as you can. If you live in the country or can get out to the country and know someone who has eggs that are fresh out of a chicken rather than the crap they have in the store that's irradiated, diseased, meat too. That's our one thing. We can't get any place around here but me. I got someone who's got some prized steers and cows, but he's not slaughtering them. He sells them whole to market. So I'll keep searching for something like that. I want to go vegan completely, but this would be a big help. Beans, zucchini, peas, broccoli, squash, tomatillos, tomatoes and peppers, and some other things. If anybody can make comments or something like that, I would appreciate it. I really will take any viable suggestion or possibility that I can see, because I've got a lot of heirloom seeds. And I got time. This is May 3rd. I got at least another 3 weeks, 4 weeks before everything should be planted. Okay? And like I said, we grow everything from seed. Nothing is bought in the store and put out here. Even if it says, oh, these are heirloom tomatoes. Yeah, okay. all of a sudden now they're gonna sell heirloom tomatoes in a store like a Kmart or a Lowe's or anything like that. No, I don't think so. And like I said, they may be, but I just don't know. We have Monsanto corn surrounding our house this summer, all the way around us. That's gonna suck. But it's a fact. You know, there's nothing we can do about that. I wish to goodness I had the money. I'd make this a giant greenhouse out here. But I can't do it. Deal with it the best I can. Please try to grow yourself some kind of food, some vegetables, healthy vegetables. Heirloom Solutions, I suggest, I recommend. I've had other sites too, but that's the first one I think of right away because that's where I got most all my seeds for the last 3 years. And I've got another 7 years of seeds for through a contract I did with them. So a contract meaning I bought something through them and then they added something if I got the extended warranty on it, which I did. So I got that 10 years of seeds. So anyway, there you go. Please plant some food so your families can be healthier. That's it.